Okay, so this is a simple shader I came up and by looking some tutorials, and it's simply two overlapping rectangles, and there is quite a bit going on. So the first thing that we can see at the top is that I have a rotate function that will make a rotation of a point. So we get a point, a vector 2 point, and the angle in radian. Then you have the big main function. And the first thing that is done is just a test that I will remove for clarity. Then we have this that will do the normalization. So now we have 1 and 1, 0 to 1, and 0 to 1, and 0 to 1 for each component. This line save the point itself before the transformation, so we can go back to the original situation. This is to offset the plane. So if I do that, now it's linked to the it will offset the plane of the red rectangle. And because I'm using only one float, it's like if I had a vector with 0.7 twice, so I could enhance this by doing something like this. And now, if I click on this, I can move my rectangle, which is nice. Okay, and then I have a mask, which is simply a bit mask that will say, is this pixel on or off? So I begin with a pixel on, so that will be displayed. And now I'm doing the rotation of the plane, so that the plane that contains the red rectangle. And then I take x and y that I put in variable, and I will use this to make the rectangle. So this is the rectangle, and I can change the sides independently. And so that's how the rectangle works. And then I apply the color to the mask. So I say R1, R1 is the rectangle one, the red one. So that's all it says. It clip a plane, a red plane with the current mask. Then I reset the transform, and I could also do the clarification here, vector 2, dot 5, dot 5. And this will be the offset for the green rectangle. So now I can move my green rectangle too. And then I have the rotation to rotate the plane. And the plane rotates around its origin. So if we shift the origin, we shift the rotation too. So if I do that, and I rotate, the rotation as a center has changed. I will put back this like here. Then I do the same stuff with the x and y, and I create the second rectangle. It's the same way, function the same way. And now it's the hard part that will come. So I add the rectangle to mask to the global mask, so that will cut this shape. And now I can add the mask and color the only the rectangle to mask. So that's why I use the temporary variable. It's to clip to the rectangle. And this one is almost as complicated as all the remaining code. So basically it says I will take, so you see a multiplication here, and this multiplication will clip everything that is on the right to the mask, because if there is zero, it will be zero, so that will remove stuff, and if it's one, it will let the stuff go through. Then you have the rectangle one, and the rectangle one is the red one, multiplied by the inverse of the rectangle mask. So we want everything outside the green rectangle to be colored in red, and that means that everything inside the rectangle will be removed. And then we add the rectangle too. So we will remove every R1 which is in rectangle 2, and then we will add rectangle 2 over. So that's a simple set operation. And this number is just the alpha, so you can dim the drawing by making it more transparent. But yeah, so not very useful, but okay, that's it. And that's how this shader works. If I do remove this, and this do simply, so if I do like a plus and zero time, so I just, by doing this, I remove that part, and so it becomes R1 plus R2. Then we can see that the two rectangles got mixed, and that's why we have yellow. And yeah, of course, we can still do the rotation, etc. Just that we did change the, and now I can choose if I want to enable this. So I remove this, and it's again enabled. And that's it for this shader. That's very basic shader, but it shows how you can use multiple objects and layer them and transform them, translate, rotation, put color on them. So that's the basics needed to compose something. And in a few minutes.